On Saturday, March 19, 1960, Kansas City insurance agent James Kinne confronted his wife Sharon about her extramarital affair, mounting debts, and his plans for filing for divorce the following Monday. The police were called to the Kinne house that evening. James Kinne was dead, shot in the head with a starter pistol. His wife Sharon said it was their 2-year-old daughter Dana who had accidentally pulled the trigger. A month after James's death, Sharon collected the life insurance and went on a wild spending spree. She bought a blue Ford Thunderbird and began an affair with the car salesman Walter Jones. In May of 1960, Walter Jones's wife Patricia went missing. The last person to see her? Sharon Kinne. Patricia Jones had been shot 4 times and her body left at Lover's Lane on the southeast side of Kansas City. Sharon Kinne was charged with the murders of both her husband and Patricia Jones. But without the murder weapon, Sharon Kinne was found not guilty for the murder of Patricia Jones. She was convicted of her husband's murder, but the conviction was overturned by the Missouri Supreme Court. Her second trial ended in a mistrial, third trial ended in a hung jury, and before her fourth trial could start, Sharon Kinne left for Mexico. In Mexico, Sharon and a man, Francisco Perades Ordonez, checked into a motel registering as man and wife. Several hours later, Sharon shot Ordonez twice in the heart. Sharon tried to get away, but the gate to the motel was locked. When the motel manager, Enrique Rueda, refused to open the gate, Sharon shot him as well. He then managed to wrestle the gun away from her and held her for the police. Her crime in Mexico earned her the name La Pistolera. Ballistics testing proved the gun used to kill Francisco was also the missing murder weapon used to kill Patricia Jones. A jury found Sharon Kinne guilty and sent to Mexican prison for 13 years. On December 7, 1969, Sharon Kinne disappeared from Ixtapalapa Women's Prison and was never seen again. Sharon Kinne has the longest current outstanding arrest warrant for murder in the history of Kansas City, Missouri, and one of the longest outstanding felony warrants in American history. Bloody Mo continues next Monday on Flatland, KCPT's digital magazine.